Well, Mr. Maker is a superstar to the under-sixes and the British TV host has brought his love of crafty sparkle to Australia for the very first time. Let's check him out.
Let's make it! You'll need a washing up glove and some other things from the doodle drawers. A small cardboard box with a lid. Some modelling clay. Some paper and some tissue paper. And some glue and some scissors.
Mr.
Maker! Yay! Please welcome Mr. Maker's alter ego, Phil Gallagher. We're all getting into the spirit, Mr. Maker, with the bottle cleaners. We're making little moustaches out of them. For those people who aren't familiar with Mr. Maker, what's it all about?
Well, it's an arts and crafts show. At its heart, but also it's done with lots of fun as well. It's a comedic show, and we try to inspire the little ones that watch the show and the grown-ups as well to get creative.
So there's an old showbiz adage that don't work with kids or animals. So what's it like working with kids?
Oh, I love it. I absolutely love it. I think it's probably because I'm a big kid myself. I enjoy it so much. When I was growing up, I always loved making things and being creative. And now it's a bit of a dream come true for me to be doing it as a job.
So do you have Mr. Maker groupies? People at the stage door waiting for autographs?
Sometimes. I heard that some of you are in pantomime this year. I do pantomimes back at home in the UK. And sometimes, yeah, we get Mr. Maker fans at stage door. Quite often the mums and dads and grandparents as well come to say hello, which is really nice. And it's great to hear what they think about the show as well.
Mr. Maker, I'm a huge fan, as are my two young daughters. You are going to show us how to do some craft, because what I love about the craft you do, it's simple. So even a mum can do it. So talk us through making a pom-pom bug. So we've got these little thingies, and what do we need to do?
Have you got everything there?
Yes, everything.
We do.
Well, you need to start off with your pipe cleaners, first of all. You've got four of those, and basically you put them down one after the other on top of each other to make a sort of star shape.
Then
make sure you can find the one that's at the bottom of the pile. Use that to wrap around the others so it looks a bit like this. A bit like a wobbly star.
Got it.
And then start to bend the ends into leg and feet shapes like this. Now, you can make them as wiggly as you like. So you know now that you've got eight wiggly legs. Like that.
So much better than an iPad, like isn't it?
I know, it's brilliant, isn't it?
Look at that.
There you go. Right, you can put that down. Now you need your glue stick. Have you got a good glue stick?
Yeah, we've got some good glue here.
I hope that. Me too. Other brands are available.
OK, so we got the glue, and then we put that one in the middle.
In the middle, a big splodge, though. Make sure it's a big splodge.
Yep.
And then put on your pom-pom and give it a good squeeze.
Yeah.
And then you can see it's starting to take shape.
Okay. I love it!
And now you just need to put some glue on the googly eyes. Now, anyone that watches Mr. Maker...
Yeah, we love googly
eyes.
Know
the googly eyes. You need those. And then you can just stick them on.
Oh, I love it.
One googly eye and then another, and you've made a fantastic furry friend.
Oh, yay.
There you go.
How quick's that? That's so quick.
There you go.
And look, you can have a family of them.
Mine's a cyclops.
Yeah. That's great fun.
You were also a veteran of British Panto, and you've starred in Aladdin. Now, Dicko, Jono and Jessica, they're about to debut in Aladdin. Do you have any tips for them?
Yeah, get fit before the Panto season is the biggest tip. Make sure you eat well, get as much rest as you can in between shows, because normally the schedule is quite gruelling. But the main thing is to enjoy it. I absolutely love pantomime and the interaction with the audience. You never know what's going to happen. You have a script, you have a plan, but every show's going to be different. And you never know what's going to happen.
Oh, no, it isn't.
It is.
Oh, actually, no, it isn't.
I'd like to say, I don't know whether Jono will remember this, but in the late 90s, he came on Disney Channel in the UK, and I actually met him at the stage door, and I made him a cup of tea and some toast that day.
Oh.
A long time ago.
I do
he
actually...
He won't remember me.
I do remember because I used to live around the corner from the Disney Channel, and I do remember... Because I was looking at you and I'm going, that's Phil. I thought, either a stand-up comedian or a man who made the best cup of tea in the UK, or Mr. Maker, who is a legend. Yeah.
That's
lovely bloke. Enjoy your time in Oz. And for details on where you can see Mr. Maker, head to livenation.com.au. And to continue the fun, our studio audience is all going home with a Mr. Maker felt scenes pack.
Wow. Wow. That's great.
Thank you, Mr. Maker. It's lovely having you on
Thank
the show.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Now, still to come on Studio 10, it's official, your boss could be making you sick. We're going to talk about that and lots more after the break.
Get away from her, you...
Anyone can search for intelligent life from a faraway galaxy. But only Robbo can do it dressed as a Rastafarian smurf. What? Oh, I see. He's from Avatar. Robbo goes where no man has gone before. Plus, he's the Aussie mentalist turning heads wherever he goes. Australia's top mentalist and hypnotist, Phoenix, performs exclusively for us. That's all to come right here on Studio 10.